thanks for getting my name almost right there. Great. My name is Anurag. It's great to be here. Great to be talking about two topics that are really close to my heart, fashion and technology. I lead a team called Vota at Myntra, formerly called Rapid, which is into technology and hardcore technology, solving problems of fashion world, right from getting the customer insights to the supply chain. How do you deliver the fashion to the customers? Thanks, Gunjan, for all wonderful customer insights that you shared. Let me start with one. All of us know that social media is very popular now, and the implication of that is that the worldview of the customer is changing. Brand is no longer the place where the customer is actually looking for fashion trends. It's actually all over the world. It's the Instagrams and Pinterest of the world. It is Facebook. It's all the e-commerce sites of the world, because they are not looking at what's there only in their country. They're also looking at fashion bloggers, influencers, celebrities, and whatnot. This has really expanded the dimension of the customer. And another important thing to note here is that these customers display their preferences in varied form over these platforms. On Instagram, it can be sharing or liking some pictures. On e-commerce, it's simply browsing those portals and looking at various styles out there. In celebrity fashion magazines, it can be commenting on those things. So customers are looking at various things, and they're expressing their opinions. They're expressing their choices in various different formats. The other point is the way fashion is getting created these days. I mean, it's no longer a time when you have two fashion seasons, right? You don't even have four fashion seasons. You have so many seasons that the definition of season itself has blurred. It has created a constant stream of newness where everyone wants to have the most precious thing on the block. The major implication of that is that it creates trends. And these trends are really, really short-lived. It's very important for you to understand what those trends are and be able to react to them in time, because that's what the customers are looking for. Customers are ready to pay the premium for getting those trends in time. Now, this all sounds good, right? I mean, all of us know about this, but where is the catch? The catch is the data. Let's just talk about a very simple thing. Imagine that you're a designer who's trying to design dresses and wants to know what is trending in the world. Just go to Instagram and check out hashtag dresses. You would find more than 77 million images stacked to it. Go to the top 10 websites or e-commerce portals of the world and search for something related to dresses. You would find more than 100,000 styles stacked to it. Now, the problem is that when a human being is actually looking at all this, a human being can look at what, like 500 styles, 1,000, 2,000? But what about 77 million? No human being has actually that kind of attention span and that kind of a ability to find out trends amongst this kind of data. So it's very important for brands to understand what is it that amongst these copious amounts of data, copious amounts of styles that is there in the world, what is it that's doing well? And more importantly, why is it doing well? And that will help them answer and understand the customer preferences and also understand whether they are doing the right thing for their customers or not. How do we actually answer all these questions, right? And that's where technology comes in. We've been talking about all these big words so far in this conference, like, you know, things like natural language processing, computer vision, machine learning. These are exactly the things that are going to help brands get to that design, which will help them act in real time and very actionable. I'm going to talk a little bit more about what these things mean in context of a fashion and for a brand, and how we at Vota are actually using these. These things, when used properly, can actually help you cut down your design times from, you know, the months that you're spending today to a matter of weeks, and will also help your designs become more intelligent. And I call them intelligent because these are based on data. These are based on hard facts and not somebody's opinion. Let me talk about NLP. You have scores of fashion blogs. You have scores of social media portals where people are talking about fashion-related terms all the time. Now, NLP is a technology which can actually help you figure out what are those fashion-related words combined with the right fashion taxonomy. And mind you, this is not like a normal Google search where you're looking for a dress and you're getting a result. This is very, very contextual. It is like a human being reading a fashion blog and making an opinion about it. So if you're searching for a word like flare, you would not only understand whether the flared is related to a hemline or is it related to a sleeve, whether we are talking about a dress or we are talking about a top, and whether what the people are talking about is in a positive connotation or a negative connotation. So in a sense, you are able to understand all the trends properly, along with a sense of why they are being talked about there. And this can be done at scale by machines. The result is you get real-time trends from all these social media information. Computer vision, another fancy term. What does it mean? I talked about those 77 million images which are there on Instagram, right? You know those are dresses, but do you know what kind of dresses those are? Do you know whether they are a solid dress or a printed dress, they are a short dress or a long dress, what kind of print they have? To understand that, computer vision can actually help you look at those images and get to a very detail around what kind of dresses those are. In this kind of an example, we are here talking about a t-shirt, and we are able to tell exactly using our algorithms that what kind of neck type it has, what kind of sleeve it has, what kind of sleeve type it has, what kind of print it has. And this can be done at scale. This can be done to all those 77 million images that we have seen. This will actually help you understand not only what kind of images are trending, but also what is it about those images that's making them trend. Another technology that we use is called machine learning, right? Again, this is once you have those images and then you have all the data about them, that what are those images all about, how do you actually at scale understand what is doing good and what is not? Because there are so many sorts of signals. Now here, machine learning kicks in. It can take into account variety of signals. If the information is on social media, it can look at likes, comments, shares, or pins, and understand whether style A is being liked more than a particular style B. It can look at global e-commerce sales data and decide in that based on its assortment, visibility, the kind of discounts they're offering, what style is doing better than the other. And it can also do it at an attribute level because you have already used computer vision to find out what those attributes are. The result is that it's actually able to give you a recipe. It's actually able to give you that these are the attributes which are in isolation or in combination to each other are working very well within a particular design. These insights are really actionable. You can actually take them and you can implement them in your designs. And that's what we have done at Vorta. We collaborated with MFB to launch two brands in this using these kind of technology. The two brands are Moda Rapid and Here and Now. We have been actually working on them since the last 2 years. Moda Rapido, launched in 2015, is today Myntra's most profitable brand. And it's not just the most profitable brand, a niche brand. It is actually scaling at 200% year on year. Okay, Moda Rapido is a good example. Then we thought, you know, let's push it. And we launched another brand called Here and Now about 7 months ago. This again has seen a phenomenal growth. It is the second largest apparel brand in Myntra in less than 7 months of its listing. This actually shows you the power of insights when done well, what kind of results they can deliver. Now, for us, launching these brands and doing is not the end. It's a means to do something better. And that's what we have been doing. We have been constantly learning and enriching our algorithms and enriching our approach through these kind of initiatives. Today, if you look at it, we are able to analyze the behavior, the shopping behavior, the browsing behavior of more than 35 million customers every month. We look at more than 14,000 social media portals, blogs, and celebrity portals to understand what are they talking about. At any point of time, we are tracking globally more than 4 million styles and how they have been doing. And we have refined this over more than 200 drops that we have created for Moda Rapido and Here and Now over the last 2 years. This has enabled us to deliver more than 1,200 styles every month with a team of nearly 4 or 5 designers. And these are really impactful designs. They are actually delivering a sell-through of more than 60% every month. We thought this is cool. Now, what do we do next? We have now come out with a product called Vorta, which is an enterprise solution. We have taken all the technology that we have developed and packaged into one solution, which is available for the brands. And it offers them insights on what's working well for them, what's not working well for them, and what are the areas they should be looking in. Recipes which are very specific, let's just say, ingredients of what should go into a successful design. Trends. Trends are around what's the chatter in the social media related to fashion. And another cool thing that we're working on, which will come out very soon, is curation. Given a particular design, we can predict whether it's going to do well or not. And these insights are at an attribute level, so they are very actionable. We are going to tell that you have to invest in solid dresses or floral dresses. And also give the magnitude of the investment that you should be making in that. And also recipes, which are again very visual way to depict what you should be working on. Trends also, something that's the chatter that's happening in social media around, you know, what's working well and what's not working well on social media, again in a very visual way. Great. I think that's it from my side. I'm happy to talk about it more. We are right opposite to the agenda board in the stall number A. You guys are welcome to have there with look at the product or have any questions. I'm happy to answer them. Thank you.
Thank you very much. And let's put our hands together for Mr. Anurag Bangana Mamula.